Financial support for Kentucky Afield is provided in part by Clay Tire of Grayson. Cars and trucks, farm or trail, providing Eastern Kentucky a grip on adventure, wherever the road may lead. Paget Incorporated is a proud sponsor of Kentucky Afield. With the area's leading construction projects, telecommunications towers, sporting business and manufacturing facilities, Paget keeps business and community on the rise.
All right, now if you see one of our law enforcement officers driving down the road and it says canine on the side and you're wondering what we use them for, check this out.
All right, come on.
We train our dogs to track and to locate weapons and to locate hidden game. So you and I are going to play the bad guys today. We're going to be trespassing and poaching deer. As we're walking now, we're breaking this grass. They're gonna smell where we stepped. Plus, you and I are shedding skin cells. It's called scurf. Our scurfs are different. They smell different to the dog. That's because what we eat,
right,
the deodorants we use, the soap we use, the shampoo we use, all of that makes our unique scent. But now, if you and I were a poacher out in the field and we heard the game warden coming, we wouldn't want to get caught with this, would we?
No, absolutely.
Well, let's hide it. And throw it right up in there. And put a little grass over it where they can't see it. There we go. Got it hid now. If that game warden catches us, oh, we're just out for a walk,
that's
see?
That's right.
We're bird watching.
We're just hanging out. Did you see a pileated woodpecker back there?
Part of the training course is we go out and we'll fire the gun.
Hey, there's a rabbit. There's a rabbit.
Man, you beat that rabbit up.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness, buddy. Here comes the game warden.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, there he is. Get rid of that gun.
We're bird watching. We're bird watching.
Yeah.
That's a hooded warbler. He wants to play, doesn't he? Search. Now, what's he do when he finds it?
You'll see. What you got?
What have you got? What have you got? Good boy.
Oh, he let you know.
Good boy. Show me. Show me what you got. Show me what you... Oh, good boy. Woo-hoo! Good boy.
So he's rewarded with a play toy.
Rewarded with a play toy.
It's all happy. It's all good for the dog.
Right.
And each time that builds the drive to follow the track.
All right. You ready to find another one? You ready?
How do these dogs know that they're one job from the other?
Well, just like we have a uniform we put on when we go to work, the dogs have a different uniform or different equipment that we put on for each task.
So with each thing, there's some sort of association. For instance, with the guns, I noticed he kept clicking the collar.
They have a nylon snap collar, and they key on the sound of the snap.
Search.
So a lot of association. They know that at that point they're looking for a gun.
Search.
So he smells that gunpowder residue and the oil.
Gunpowder residue and the oil and the actual human odor on it.
Right.
What have you got? What have you found? Good boy. What have you got?
How about that?
What have you got? Woo!
So that's part of his 10-week training to understand the smell of the gunpowder, the oil, and things that are associated with the gun. So that's part of his
scent association with play.
Right.
Good boy. Good boy. Out. See it.
How about that?
See it. Good boy.
You know, there's nothing that will ruin your hunt more than getting wet and cold. The folks at High Creek understand this. They come up with this High Creek Smart Tex. The high-tech membrane keeps out rain and wind while simultaneously allowing the moisture created by sweat to evaporate. So if you're looking for a high quality outfit that's gonna keep you protected out in the woods so your hunt will not be ruined, go to High Creek and pick up one of these pro packages and you'll be real happy that you did.
Wow.
LED technology, 3-position memory switch, and longer burn times makes Crystal Lights the right choice. Smaller, brighter, lighter Crystal Lights.
Imagine what these guys can actually smell, but you're working with them every day. I bet you think that nose is pretty fantastic.
Yeah, it'll surprise you. It'll really open your eyes to what they're able to do. The wildlife detection dogs are really an interesting niche because there's just very few of them in the United States, and right. Kentucky is very lucky to have such a strong program that it really gives us an advantage. Very rarely do we end up having to go to court because we've got the evidence.
Yeah.
It's hard to deny it when you've got the evidence right there in your hand.
Is that it? Oh, that's a good boy.
This is Canine Ruddy.
She's going to have a different response, and explain that to
us. Yes. What she's trained for is she's trained for what we call passive alert. Instead of scratching and digging at the source, she's going to smell the meat, and then she's just going to sit down. And
that's your sign that, hey,
and that's my sign. That tells me there's something in there. Where is it? Good girl. Good girl.
He's on us right now.
He's dead on us.
We've used the dogs across the state in several poaching cases where we've actually tracked down the guy and caught him with a turkey or illegal turkey or deer. They're used a lot in trespass cases where we know the guy not supposed to be on the property, and a dog will just go find him. It's just pretty simple. when the dog comes past the gun, he may or may not find it. If he doesn't, the handler will return with his dog and find
it.
He's found it, see. So now we're ahead. If we have an Alzheimer's patient that wanders off, or a child that's lost, or a hunter that's lost.
Right, which happens.
We have been requested by state police and other police agencies to help them locate people or weapons.
Hey, Buck, good boy, good boy, good boy, Buck. Woo, good boy.
He loves his job.
He does, he loves his job, and this is why they do it.
Yeah, good boy.
They don't get any food rewards. It's all praise.
Wow. How do you pick a dog for this program? And how do
you look for a dog with high drive.
Okay.
A lot of play, a lot of extra energy.
Right.
And then we channel that energy and play into what we want them to do. And the bond between the dog and the handler is almost as strong a bond as a child and a father.
Now let's see who else has been having fun as we check this week's ones that didn't get away.
Here's a wonderful Kentucky elk taken by Dakota Matthews. He's 11 years old with his dad, David. Congratulations. Here's Carol Kimbrough with a deer taken during muzzleloader season. It's an 8-point buck at 2.5 years old. Congratulations.
Here's Andrew Wood of Kenton County with his first deer. Wow, 11 years old. Kenton County 10-pointer. Congratulations. Here's Trevor Simpson, 10 years old. Took this nice turkey during the youth season. 8-inch double bearded turkey. Congratulations. Okay, here's Bruce Hogger and grandson Brandon Hollingsworth doing some trout fishing below Wolf Creek Dam. Congratulations. Here's Kaylin Wilson, opening day of youth season in Hardin County. 20 pounds, 11-inch beard, and 1-inch spurs. Congratulations. Here's Brendan Simon, 9 years old, with a nice turkey. It's 20 pounds, 1-inch spurs, and 10¾-inch beard. Congratulations. Here's Danny Cornett, and he caught these fish at Martin's Fork Lake in Harlan County. One of them's about 6 pounds, and the other one's 5 pounds, 6 ounces. Caught 20 minutes apart. Congratulations. Here's John Summerfield, 13 years old, from Louisville, with his first wild turkey, 25 pounds, 10-inch beard, and 3/4-inch spurs. Congratulations. Here's Kurt Conyers from Mount Vernon, Indiana. Took his first Kentucky deer 10-pointer in Ohio County. Congratulations. Here's Cole Howard with his first big gobbler. He's 7 years old at his papa's farm in Breckenridge County. Opening day of youth hunt. Congratulations. Here's Kyle Ash, 9 years old, first turkey on a youth hunt. It's a Jake, and he's hunting with his dad on a farm in Boone County. Congratulations. Here's Steve Higdon with his first turkey. He's 51 years old, taken in Hart County on opening day. Congratulations. Justin Hunter from Anderson County is 6 years old, and he took this spike buck in Shelby County. He's hunting with his father, Alex. Congratulations. Send your non-returnable picture to the one that didn't get away, number one Sportsman's Lane, Frankfort, Kentucky, 40601. Remember, hunting and fishing on private property is a privilege. Always ask permission and thank the landowner. Till next week, I'm Tim Farmer. Hope to see you in the woods or on the water.
Watching Lakeland TV, your one-stop station for lake information.